There's so many different varieties of animals that live in here. You just can't believe how much of a ecosystem is sitting right at your footstep.
It's pretty cool to see the birds here.
It's pristine, it's alive, it's fresh. There's new things coming in here. The birds are thick. This is it. This is really good stuff.
Wetlands are among the richest and most diverse places on Earth. They provide shelter for animals. Thousands of fish, mammals, and birds call the wetlands home. If you can believe it, wetlands, thick with plants and soggy soils, act as a sponge, soaking up pollutants to help keep our water clean. They also help protect people from floods and storms. Aquatic habitats like these along the Gulf Coast are vital to seabirds, fish, and shellfish. Economically, the Gulf alone contributes billions to our economy and supports millions of jobs. Sometimes, in places where communities are growing along the coast, wetlands are paying the price. In some places, these once biologically rich areas are filled in and developed into homes. Others are turned into farmland or industrial sites. As a result, our wetlands are disappearing, and with them, the fish that live there, the same fish that we catch and eat at home. But the news is not all bad. Scientists are finding that protection and restoration are making a difference. At a time when people are losing their jobs and our economy is troubled, should restoring wetlands be a priority? Fortunately, in many cases, conserving wetlands also supports a healthier economy. In 2009, President Obama signed an economic stimulus law that would send a portion of funding to restore coastal areas while creating jobs for those living nearby. Here in Huntington Beach, California, $3 million went to support the restoration of Magnolia Marsh Wetland, which is surrounded by a thriving coastal community. It is estimated that the economic benefits of this restoration equals billions of dollars per year.
This is essentially a group of local people that saw a cause and decided to take action themselves. They said to the government, give us the tools, give us the resources, and we'll do the project. Wetlands Conservancy was able to acquire the property and preserve it as open space wildlife habitat.
But the marsh was cut off from seawater for more than 100 years, and people, birds, and fish were nowhere to be found. In 2010, after a few months of construction, the wetland was restored. Not only did this effort provide jobs for 45 local residents, but today, Magnolia is on the road to recovery. Water floods its land once again. The fish and wildlife are returning, including important commercial fish like California halibut.
Putting water back into these wetlands, it creates really important nursery habitat for fish species like halibut, which will then grow up in these nurseries and then enter back into the system and be available for fishers to fish and consume, and then also be great habitat for fish in the future.
What this project shows is that nature has an amazing capacity to recover if you give it a chance to do so.
Restoration requires help from the entire community.
We've left our mark on something that, you know, is going to be here for a long time for my kids and other kids to enjoy, and it's definitely makes me proud to see that this is completed and not just a big dump site that it was before.
This project has provided a job for me, but in addition to that, it has also improved the environment in our community.
Over 90% of the wetlands in California are gone. So this is a celebration.
People can now enjoy the beauty of this area and participate in many recreational activities.
We're here to look at birds and fish for Cub Scouts.
This is a real gift to the nation. We need to value and protect our coastal habitats, and this is a tremendously exciting way to do it. This is an opportunity to draw attention to how important these places are, how much they deserve our protection, how much we benefit from them. And from a scientific standpoint, it's just so exciting to have the opportunity to participate in this.
Wetland restoration, creating jobs, supporting local economies, protecting the environment, doing our part to preserve wildlife, and an ocean we can all enjoy for generations to come.